I'm AJ, and thanks for clicking on this video. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button right now. Hit that like button because you're going to like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. So today I'm doing a review of the WeBull trading app. WeBull was created in 2017. It is an online trading app, so you can access it by going on your desktop or your laptop computer, or also using your smartphone, either on iOS or Android. Now, this is one of the many trading apps out there that are available, and I think some of the features you may really like, especially if you're new to investing or if you like to save money. So with the WeBull application, one of the great things about this application is that you can trade stocks for free. So there's no charge to buy stocks, bonds, ETFs, or index funds. And because of that, it makes it one of the better trading applications out there. So WeBull falls in line with Robinhood and M1 Finance as some of the mobile trading platforms that allow you to trade stocks for free. So in that sense, it is one of the better platforms. There are also no minimum balances you need to keep in order to create an account. Now, there is a minimum deposit for one of the features that makes it one of the better platforms, and I'll get into that later into this video. So for those who are not beginners, this may be a feature that you are very interested in. So with WeBull, unlike Robinhood, you can trade stocks on margin and there's no fee. So with Robinhood, if you trade stocks on margin, there's a monthly fee to sign up for Robinhood Gold, which is $10 per month. And that gives you access to be able to trade stocks on margin. For those unfamiliar with margin is basically borrowing money from the brokerage in order to buy stocks. So let's say you wanted to buy $2,000 worth of stock, but you only had $1,000 of cash actually available in your account. So you can borrow the other $1,000 from the brokerage account, and they will charge you an interest rate just like any other loan company would charge you for interest on that account. And once you buy the stock, you will get all of the gains that you would have made just as if you had your own $2,000 in the stock. But once you sell it, you still owe the brokerage company $1,000, and you have to give them that money back or continue to pay interest on the money that you borrowed. So I'll give an example of someone that's trading a stock on margin and just talk about the pros and cons of using margin. Although I don't recommend this for people that are new to investing, this is more for the advanced person who actually knows what they're doing with picking individual stocks. So an example of using margin, again, let's say you have $2,000 worth of stock, $1,000 of that is borrowed from the brokerage and $1,000 is your own cash. So let's say the stock doubles and now it's the $2,000 worth of stock that you have is now worth $4,000. You know, not getting into the amount of time that you held the stock, basically out of that $4,000, because you borrowed $1,000 of it, once you sell it, the brokerage now gets their $1,000 back and now you have $3,000 worth of cash. Now, if you only had the $1,000 worth of cash and the stock doubled, of course you would only have $2,000 in cash once you sell after that stock doubles. But because you were also able to borrow $1,000 on margin, your $2,000 turned into $4,000, you sold the stock, you paid the brokerage back their $1,000, and now you have $3,000. Now the con in this situation is if the stock actually goes down. So if you have $2,000 worth of stock, $1,000 is borrowed, $1,000 is your own cash, and let's say the stock drops by 50%. So your $2,000 worth of stock turns into $1,000 worth of stock. Now, instead of only losing half of the money that you actually put in this instance, you actually lose 100% of what you put in because you still have to pay back the brokerage the $1,000 that you borrowed. And now your $2,000 worth of stock is only worth $1,000. So your initial $1,000 of cash that you actually put in now has to go back to the brokerage because you borrowed $1,000 from them. So you essentially have no money left over in this situation because the stock is only worth $1,000 and you borrowed $1,000 from the brokerage. Now, of course, in both of the examples that I used, when you doubled the amount of stock that you had and when you lost half of the stock value that you had, I haven't considered what the interest rate was for having the money that you borrowed from the brokerage account. So you have to keep in mind that during the time that you're borrowing this money, the brokerage is also making money off of the money that they loaned you via the interest rate. So for beginners, I definitely would not recommend you borrowing on margin, but this is an option that's available to you and there's no extra fee or no minimum deposit that you have to make in order to trade on margin. Another feature that I like about Webull is the fact that you can create a paper trading account. So similar to TD Ameritrade, if you watch one of my previous videos, I talked about how TD Ameritrade was the first platform that I ever used for trading. And the main reason that I used their platform is that they had a paper trading option. So with paper trading, you can go out and you can basically practice investing, practice making trades, and without actually using your own money and potentially making a mistake, whether it's, you know, buying a stock that you didn't mean to, maybe buying a dollar amount that you didn't mean to. Although that's a lot harder when you don't have a margin account. If you have a cash account, it's only going to allow you to purchase the actual cash that you have in your account. So for those who are beginners, it's great to be able to paper trade and learn how the platform that you're using actually works and not make any mistakes and also not lose any real money. Now, getting back to what I mentioned earlier about minimum deposits. So there is no minimum deposit just to create an account. But one of the great things about Webull is that if you use someone else's link to sign up for the account, both you and that person will receive a free share of stock. So when I signed up for Webull, I used someone else's link and I received a free share of Genworth Financial. Their stock ticker is GNW, just for signing up. So the stock that you receive is randomly selected. It could be anywhere from a $3 stock up to a $1,000 stock. So that means you're not gonna get Amazon as one of these options because it's a stock that's more than $1,000. But also the odds of you getting one of the higher, you know, something closer to $1,000 is a lot lower than it is that you'll get a $3 or $5 stock. So when I signed up, I got a $3 stock. And if you sign up using my link, you can get a stock anywhere between $3 and $1,000. It's a higher chance that you'll get one of the lower stocks. But the point is that you're getting a free stock just for signing up and putting in an initial deposit of $100 or more. And so I emphasize initial because if you put in $50 this week and then you wait until next week to put in another $50 and now you have your $100 deposit, you won't actually get the free share of stock that way. Your initial first deposit has to be at least $100 or more, and then that'll make you eligible to receive that free share of stock. So make sure once you click the link in my description, if you decide to open a Webull account, that when you make your initial deposit, it's at least $100. And then both you and I will receive a free share of stock that is randomly selected by Webull. Now, also very similar to Robinhood, but what makes it distinct from one of my favorite platforms, which is M1 Finance and Stockpile, with Webull and Robinhood, although they're free trading apps, you have to buy a full share of stock. So if you're looking for a high price stock like an Amazon, which is over $1,000, or, you know, another stock that maybe a couple of $100, you have to have that amount of money in your account in order to buy that one share. But with M1 Finance and Stockpile, who I recently did a review of, you can actually buy partial shares on their platforms. So if you don't have a lot of money to invest, maybe Webull might not be the option for you unless you're buying a stock, you know, that doesn't cost a lot of money and you can actually afford to buy an individual share of whatever stock you're trying to purchase. Now, if you're looking to buy a very high priced stock, or if you don't have a lot of money to invest, you know, if you're looking to put maybe just 10, 20, or maybe $50 to $100 every pay period and you want to put that amount in your brokerage account, then Webull might not be the option for you unless you're buying a lower price stock. So that was my review of Webull's mobile trading platform. If it's something that you use, or if based on the features that I mentioned, if it's something that you plan to use, make sure you leave some comments down below. If you would like to sign up for Webull, again, you get a free share of stock and so do I if you sign up using my link. So make sure you use the link that I've left down in the description. I really appreciate you guys taking this time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Make sure you hit that like button because you really like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, I really appreciate you taking this time out of your day. Thanks and have a great day.